This is my gas-powered string trimmer, and it's not working too well. The last time I used it, it was bogging down when I squeezed the throttle. I suspected the gas filter was clogged up, so I just took it off so that I could continue to use the trimmer and get my chores done. Since then, I've purchased a new gas filter, so let's go ahead and install it. It's supposed to be located inside of the gas tank. But before I install it, I need to retrieve the end of the gas line, and I'll use these needle nose pliers to do just that. There it is. And here is a package of new gas filters. All I need is one. So let me grab some scissors. And hopefully I can cut this open without stabbing myself. And there you go. Now the new gas filter. Simply pushes on to the end of the gas line. And just like that. Now let's just tuck it back into the gas tank, and we're finished. And put the scissors away. Now, while I have the string trimmer on my workbench, I'm going to go ahead and restring the spool. Because as many of you know, that when you use these things, you're constantly feeding out string only for it to wear down and be cut off by the cut blade. This new string is 80 thousandths in diameter. The white string is also 80 thousandths in diameter. So I just need to get off what's left of the white string. Now, this spool is meant to be strung in such a way that when you're finished, you actually have two ends. In other words, you have two cutting edges. But the way I string it, I only have one cutting edge, but I have twice as much string. And my reasoning is I can cut twice as much grass. If you're not familiar with a string trimmer, you probably will not notice as you watch me string this that I'm not doing it the way the manufacturer says I should. But I've done this for years, and it works rather well. Now, some of you may think that I must really love doing yard work because I have, you know, two or three of these videos where I maintain my equipment. And let me assure you that I do not enjoy yard work at all. As a matter of fact, I almost despise it. But it has to be done. You can't let your property go. You have to take care of it. Let's go ahead and cut this. And let's go ahead and feed back the excess string. And let's put it away. Just need to feed the string through the little hole. There's actually two holes, but like I mentioned, I only use one of them. And let's put the bump button back on. Whenever you bump this button against the ground, it feeds out more string. And that worked out pretty good. Now let's put our stuff away. And I'll take this time to tell you that I appreciate you guys watching my videos. Thank you.